100 meteorologists using the most advanced radar, live Super Doppler HD, keeping you safe under an umbrella protection.
Well, 82 degrees, not bad yesterday. This hour, we were in the 90s already. In fact, well into the 90s. Our feels like temperature was in the triple digits right now. 85, much better. Dew points at 67. We have an east-southeast wind currently around 6 miles per hour. Not too bad at all. Now, notice we do still have a couple of storms ongoing. Here's the metro area. No storms here at all. We've been dry for the last several hours after a round of some quick showers and storms this morning. Notice as you get up towards Jewell Radcliffe and just north of there and east of Webster City, we're seeing some of those showers. Maybe a storm just northeast of Stratford there. You can see a little bit of red on there indicating it's probably pouring a little heavier there. You may catch a rumble of thunder as well, but really not a whole lot there. From the morning showers, notice where most of it took place. Picked up about a third of an inch here in the metro, about 3/4 of an inch in Fort Dodge. That was over the last 24 hours, these are the rainfall totals we've been seeing. The excessive heat warning's really been trimmed back quite a bit. Notice it only includes the southeast corner of the state now. Cold front working its way through the state. It's almost entirely through, but it's starting to stall out. So I don't think we're going to see much of a cool off here over the next couple of days for that reason. I'll explain why in just a second. Temperatures much cooler, though, behind that front where it's been raining north and west of us. 73 Fort Dodge. Doesn't that sound nice? 82 in the metro, 84 Ottumwa. 85 right now, Lamoni, and then off towards Council Bluffs, they're at about 81 degrees. And the dew points for all of us in the 60s, much better, much more comfortable out there, still just a little bit on the sticky side. So there's the showers from earlier this morning pushing off to the north and east. Notice they've stayed generally north of I-80 over the last few hours, but this little area over here into eastern Nebraska will likely see getting a little bit closer to us late today. So I think most of it for the next several hours will stay north of I-80, but this little batch right here eventually is going to probably swing around and could clip us here in the metro late this afternoon and this evening. And then we'll likely see some more storms firing up along this warm frontal boundary later on this evening. And then those are going to ride towards us a little bit later on tonight. Those probably get here maybe 3, 4, 5 o'clock in the morning, something like that. And a couple of those could be on the strong side. That's why we have a slight risk for the southwest corner, pretty much from Des Moines south and westward through late evening and overnight tonight. We'll keep that going for you. Here's Futurecast. We skip ahead to 3 p.m. Notice a little break off to the north. Some showers starting to redevelop off to our west. We could see some of those swinging in this evening. Notice by about 7, 8 o'clock, we're starting to see some showers here, some storms north and west of us. Then as we go through the overnight hours, some of that moves out. We could see another round move in late tonight, early tomorrow morning. The computer model shows them north. Some of them could still be here in the metro, though, so we'll keep that chance for a storm or two out there early in the day. Otherwise, forecast for today, temperature-wise, coolest numbers in the 80s off to the north, 90 from Des Moines and southward. We'll say heat index value still in the mid to upper 90s. Could see some triple digits down towards the Missouri border. Scattered storms stay north over the next few hours, but by this evening and tonight, we'll see more of those scattered storms arriving here in central Iowa as well. 74, some storms tonight could be severe. That's the low temperature. 93 on Friday, so really we're not done with the heat yet. Do we have triple digits in the forecast? No, and we didn't get there over the last few days. We were pretty close, but notice we'll keep it in the lower to mid-90s for the next several days. We'll still call that hot and humid, but just not as bad as it has been. Chances for rain really not going anywhere over the next several days. It'll be hit or miss. We do get some dry time early next week, and we'll enjoy some upper 80s with that, so kind of a break.
Absolutely. And I was just thinking, I can finally get outside this afternoon and enjoy this for a little bit. I've kind of been cooped inside. It's just been too hot.
Almost overwhelming. I agree.
Thanks, Wes.